Dan Radio Style, that's Supertramp doing Give a Little Bit, obviously a remix, if you will, of Supertramp's version of that song, or their song, actually, Give a Little Bit. Great song, and I love the Goo Goo Dolls, and I absolutely love the way that song comes out when they do it, so, just to be a little different, there you go. And, of course, Dan Radio Style, like I promised, hope everybody out there is having themselves a wonderful day. This show, I must say, was inspired by one of the viewers, one of the commenters, and she has her own channel, and I'm going to give her a plug. I don't normally give plugs. You guys probably find that, and don't think that this is a way to get plugs from me, because I don't give them as a rule, but every once in a while, I will change that rule when I want to. So anyway, Pamela Sosnowski, I want to thank you for this, by the way, because it was your comment that actually inspired this this concept, and it made a lot of sense to me, and it was just a brilliant idea, and it's something that she's doing right now, just kind of having fun with Law of Attraction or Manifesting or Goddard or whoever, manifesting basically, and it really made me realize, for those of us that are working on manifesting the big thing, maybe it's a job, right? Maybe it's your career, maybe it's a new car, maybe it's a new home, maybe it's your specific person, whatever it is that you're currently working on that you're putting a lot of efforts into, a really good technique that actually will help that manifestation without even working on it specifically is what I'm here to talk about. I have no idea what I'm going to title this. Probably something to do with the little things or Give a Little Bit, something along those lines. That's kind of why I chose that song. But really what it is, it's doing more of the little manifestations, the little things, right? In the case of Pam, what she was talking about, Pamela, she was mentioning how, you know, she'd been finding... been working on trying to find a penny, right? So she found a penny on the ground, which, by the way, is a great way to start. Try to find some sort of small monetary change or something on the ground and manifest that. And then it's very easy to do. They're plentiful. They're all over. They're abundant. But you don't necessarily expect to see them everywhere you go, right? And certainly a lot of people will pick them up. So in the case with her, she was manifesting the penny, finally manifested that. And then I think she might have bumped it up to nickels. Now she's going for quarters. And it made me realize, it's like, well, here's a fun little way to play around with the little stuff while you're working on the big things. And first off, what does that accomplish when you do that? Well, it gives you something else to focus on. Most of us, when we're going through the manifestation process and we're having difficult times with it, it's generally speaking because we're still focused on right now, on what's going on right now. Why don't I have it right now? I know there's a lot of techniques out there, you know, living in the end and all these things, and do whatever makes you feel comfortable, whatever works. Ultimately, it's how you are feeling about the whole process that actually matters, right? The imaginal work and all that. Once you've done the asking, so long as you keep your energy in a good place, that response comes. If you need to do more imaginal work to get your energy in that place, great. If you need to, you know, keep living in the end, great. If you want to try letting go, great. It is completely up to you. None of these techniques are necessarily better or worse than anything else. What is important to pay attention to is they're different for you. Not all of us have the same body types. So eating the same kinds of foods for each one of us might create a slightly different experience within our bodies, right? Some people are allergic to sugar. So if you hand them a plum and say, hey, have a bite of this plum, it'll kill them. Why, for some of other people, you know, fruit's a very, very healthy way to get some of those natural sugars in your body. So again, not everybody is the same. So stop trying to do a cookie cutter approach to fixing everything in your life. Try what works. What do you notice? Where do you notice the biggest bang for the buck? Where you feel the best at the time you're doing the appropriate work, the imaginal work, whatever it is, right? Whatever the case is, meditation, by the way, is just a great practice in general, daily, period. Like, you should just try to work that in general. It's very good. Just helps get our energy in a good place. I do it in the morning in the shower before I get my day going, and it proves out, it just proves to be a very, very good way for me to start the day. So again, why do we do the little things? Because it gives you something else to focus on. gives you something else to pay attention to. It gives you something else that's small that you will actually notice the manifestation occur. This is going to bother me if I have something in my eye, right? I got like a hair in my eye or something. Whatever. Oh, well, we'll just deal with it. That's the joy of doing live work here. It gives you something small to focus on. And then on top of that, it gives you some small victories from which to hang your hat, right? So while you're working on the big thing, and you're doing basically the same approach on a little thing, and then that little thing happens, and then you do another version of the little thing, and it happens, and then you do another version of the little thing, and it happens, it starts to give you courage and strength and a belief in the process. So the big thing, when you start seeing the little coincidences and whatnot, you can actually go, ah, yeah, it's happening. May not be right this second, may not see it right now, but it's happening. That is the power of doing the little things. So what's some of the other little things that you maybe could focus on? You know, like I like Pamela's is the, a penny and then finding a nickel or a dime or whatever monetary versions you have in your country. You know, little change things that are kind of, you know, all over the place and are really, really, you know, it's just fun to find money, right? Frankly, that's money. You could make it maybe a dollar, maybe, you know, five, whatever's a reasonable amount of money. You could make it something like someone handing you a bottle of water, for example. Maybe the parking places we've talked about. Maybe you just keep doing that one over and over and you keep finding that there's always a parking place available for you now. Always. Like every time you go down there, daily, maybe you shop. Like for me, I go to the grocery store every day, right? So you go down there and you find a spot every single time because that's what you've been manifesting. Again, it gives you that extra oomph behind your manifestation and it kind of gives you a victory, gives you a place to pat yourself on the back and go, yes, this does work. So when you're struggling, if you will, you have your doubt cycles with the bigger thing, you've now got something where you can go, well, wait, this is working. This is working fine. I've seen results. I've seen stuff come to fruition. It's happening. So it's okay. I can like hush the mind chatter a little because I know that it's working. Again, you can maybe try to get a text message from someone, not your specific person, someone else, the specific person, just leave them over there. But if you're going to try to generate a text message from someone, maybe that's one of the things you're trying to do with your specific person. Well, try to generate a text message from one of your friends, from someone that might text you, but go ahead and put that into the context of trying to get them to do it, say maybe within the next 24 hours, right? Nothing wrong with that. Or maybe try to get them to bring up something, ask you if you want to go shopping with them, whatever. Whatever the case is, something that you can definitely manifest and would be fun for you to do. Maybe even something as crazy as just getting one of your friends to offer you a cookie, right? A cookie, a sandwich, a piece of fruit, whatever. It's a chance to get you focused on something else. You're doing all this imaginal work. That's great. And stopping for a moment and doing some other piece of imaginal work isn't going to deter from this one. What it will probably do is help you because it's going to get you thinking about something else. So that's good. That's not going to take you down the negative path of why isn't it here now, right? It's not going to throw the doubts at you. You're just going to do some more imaginal work. And then when you get your successes from that smaller imaginal work, it then grants, again, more power to the stuff that you're trying to manifest that's a bit more on the challenging side. So it's a very good way to kind of just promote a stronger chance, stronger chops, if you will, on the manifestation department. Hopefully this makes a lot of sense. Hopefully it kind of helps you guys out. I thought it was a great idea. And if you guys haven't had a chance to check out Pamela's channel, feel free to do so. I think she's in the comments. You guys will find her somewhere. So yeah, be looking around for her down there. She didn't necessarily do a show on this, so I'm not necessarily linking her channel per se, but I did plug her name a bunch of times. So that should hopefully count for something. Going to be going out with a Queen song. It's a Kind of Magic, Dan Radio style.